That looks like this is an evening's
relaxation where the red crew was coming off shift. We decided to come down and bother the blue crew who was starting to try and do some work.
Notice I was working, and they made it look like so much fun that I had to stop.
It's a great zucchini acrobatic team, actually. It's processed here for about 5 seconds. There's a lot of volume in that space lab. It really is nice. See, when you've been in space a little while, down is up and up is down. It doesn't make any difference. It really doesn't.
Here we are at the end of the mission, taking off the magazine off the large format metric camera. And this is a TV shot we made looking up from the floor, again, looking at the problem of moving large objects in space. As we basically demonstrated before on Skylab, and people always continue to worry about it, you can move an object almost as large as you wish, as long as you just move it slowly. As long as the accelerations are small, we have no problem controlling and moving very large objects. See Byron here. Moving a fairly large drawer just up to stick into a cabinet and close it. It's a lot of these things just ran and slid and moved very nicely and freely in space. You see there, just up it goes and it's shut.
It's time to close the scientific airlock. You can see us view out the aft flight deck window as the table's already been moved inside and the hatch is coming down.
And here's the entry join up. Charlie Justice in his chase plane is joining up. He's getting better and better at it. And it's a beautiful day out there at Edwards. We could see the lake bed from 60 miles out and had no doubt about where we're going and what we're doing on the flying end of it. Because of our problems, we'd been up for a long time. Rooster had been up about 14 and a half, 15 hours. I'd been up about 20 and a half hours, I think. And even so, because we've had a lot of practice doing this kind of thing, it just seemed like old home week getting back there and shooting those approaches, shooting that approach. See the shallow glide slope? We're on a 17-degree, short, 17-degree glide slope. It's really a shallow glide slope. It's hard to believe that the orbiter right there weighs almost 110 tons, but it does. And it's coming down and just working beautifully. The orbiter has a lot more precision, crisp, handling qualities in the real vehicle than we've been able to do in some of our simulators, because it would take a really super actuator to make those crisp motions. And it's very straightforward. We're a little low on energy, so Brewster held the gear down to about 250 feet, but the gear still comes down locks in about 5 seconds, 6 seconds. And the ground effect model, we've never really, it's tough to simulate it just properly, but the ground effect model really cushions this baby with this big delta wing. It just cushions it beautifully right into landing there. It looks like about a 12-degree angle of attack and a straightforward landing and rollout. I think the lake bed must have been still wet a little bit because we really decelerated rapidly. We weren't using very much brakes, and we rolled a stop 10,200 feet from the threshold, which with that big payload, but at least show us something about our capability into abort fields around the world, which are a little shorter. If you look real close, you can see a little bitty nose wheel steering test in there somewhere. It's kind of hard to see from this angle. Yeah, but it's here. It sure is a delightful flying machine, and start to finish. And like I say, it weighs quite a bit, and we proved the capability to bring back on that mission over 21 tons of payload in vehicles like the Discovery. We also looked at a new flexibility and coming in over the poles almost. We're over the Aleutians and Sakhalin Island in that area. Now here you see six men getting off a spaceship after 10 days in space. They haven't had a bath. You might say this is six dirty old men, but and they probably really are looking forward to a shower. And I think they're pretty darn steady considering how long they've been up there. This is a PAO that shows how we're going to carry this on around the world tour, and we want to make sure all the, if we ever go on this around the world tour, and we want to make sure that all these people get to see their own flag. And this outstanding bunch of people, the flight control division and the entry flight control team that did that job and brought us back home safely.